And the countdown continues to the kickoff of this year's fifth Third Riverbank Run. Right now, it's just a little more than 14 hours away. There's one West Michigan man who's claimed first place in the 25K, not once, not twice, but seven times. 24 News 8's Jack Doles is in studio to talk with Greg Meyer.
Yeah, he's won the race. He's been a great ambassador to the fifth Third Riverbank Run and running in general. He's also the guy who recruits elite runners to Grand Rapids. Greg Meyer joins us live from the Runners Expo. Greg, neither defending champ will be back, and I know there was some concern about Robert Letting, who went missing. What's the latest on him? Any contact, any idea where he is?
No idea, really. I know this happens from time to time when people are coming internationally to different races. It hasn't happened to us yet. This was a first. One of the other Kenyans said he thought he heard a rumor that he went to Brazil for something, but we don't know.
All right, with the defending champs out of the picture, a wide open field now. What do you expect? Who are some people, the runners that people should watch, Greg?
You know, I think Mohamed Tefra is going to be tough. Matt Teginga is going to be tough. Christo Landry, who was third here last year, is going to be tough. Joseph Cherley. It's actually a great field on the, well, both men's and women's side. Actually, I don't think that had our last year's winner returned, he would have won again anyway. It's that strong of a field.
That's great to hear. Now, Jason Hartman of Rockford finished fourth at the Boston Marathon, top American finisher for the second straight year there, had to pull out. Why did that happen for Jason?
Well, he was never scheduled to run here this year. When you run Boston and you're 3 weeks out, Boston beats you up. And a big guy like Jason, it's even worse on your legs because of the downhill. So it was never in his plans to come this year. We have to catch him on a year where he doesn't run a spring marathon.
He's an interesting story, though, Greg. I know no sponsors on his jersey when he crossed the finish line at Boston. How difficult is it for a guy to make a living in this business?
You know, it's fairly tough. The very, very top guys these days, like a Dathan Ritzenheim and others, are making really good money. The next tier down, not so much. But I did hear that Jason does have a shoe sponsor now, and based on what he's done the last couple of years, he's doing all right through the Boston Marathon. I would guess that his take just in that race is probably more than most teachers make in a year.
Well, that works out well for him. All right, Greg, last thing for you. You know, runners always seem to have a cause. What is it about runners that makes this race so special and that bond to the community that they go out and do this kind of thing?
You know, I think sometimes it's just running gives them a mechanism to do something for somebody else. They may not get off the couch to train for their own health or, you know, for something personal, but they'll do it for somebody else. And I think that's been the thing that's triggered the running boom over the last 5 or 6 years are the charities. People want to run for a cause, and we're going to raise over $200,000 at the Riverbank Run this year, you know, and that's just incredible, and it gets people motivated. What's amazing this year, the fifth Third Riverbank Run, there's like 200 more volunteers than last year because of what happened in Boston. People said, I want to go support the race. And they came out in droves to help put this thing on. It's just what people do. When bad things happen sometimes, you find out why good things happen, you know, and why good wins.
All right, Greg, thank you very much. Thanks for all the work you do with the fifth Third Riverbank Run, and have a great race out there tomorrow.
Thanks, Jack.
A pretty amazing man, seven-time winner. We have big plans for tomorrow to bring you everything you need to know about the fifth Third Riverbank Run. Tune in for a special edition of Daybreak. We'll be live from 5 to 9 on Wood TV 8 and streaming on woodtv.com, so you can watch right from your cell phone or mobile device. We will have our studio downtown at Monroe Center in Monroe, just steps from the starting line, so you can come down and see Emily, Brett, and Terry live in action. And while you're at the race, of course, snap some photos and send them to report it at woodtv.com.